no matter where you're watching this right now. Here? Or here? Or maybe even here? Nowadays, science is everywhere. But what do people all over the world think about science and scientists? Well, that question was investigated in a survey conducted by the Wellcome Trust in 2018. They asked over 140,000 people in 140 countries. And they got some encouraging results. For example, 3/4 of the world's population have confidence in their own healthcare system. But wait a minute, does that mean 1/4 does not trust their doctors and nurses? Let's have a closer look. Germany is a country whose healthcare system did relatively well during the COVID-19 pandemic. Lisa, a philosopher and GYA member, lives there.
In Germany, trust in science seems to be quite high according to surveys, but people get suspicious whenever there are controversial political topics, and they ask whether some of the studies have been paid for by private interests. And that's, of course, a very good reason to ask critical questions.
In Germany, especially the pharmaceutical companies have to cope with a lot of distrust. That's probably one reason why some parents don't want their children to be vaccinated against measles. The same problem occurs in other countries as well. France, Ukraine, and the Philippines, for example. But in most countries of Latin America, the anti-vaccination movement isn't such an issue. At least, that's what Clarissa, another GYA member, has experienced.
In Latin America, we don't have problems of anti-vaxxers, of people thinking that vaccines are not good. On the contrary, every time that there is a new case of measles, for example, is because a kid and a family from Europe, for example, in Costa Rica, came to the airport in Costa Rica, and this was such a fuss around the country because they were angry that since they are vaccinating their children, why they will have to have this risk in their country.
Costa Rica hadn't had any cases of measles for years until, in 2019, a French family brought the disease into the country. Understandably, Costa Ricans were upset that they had to deal with measles again. Still, almost no problem with the anti-vaccination movement in Costa Rica and other Latin American countries, at least so far. But that doesn't mean all is well between science and society in this part of the world. Let's have a look at Peru. Clarissa's home country.
Sometimes in Peru we have earthquakes, and when that happens, there are many physicists that go to the TV channels and they talk about what has happened and what are the implications of this. But we also have some TV programs that bring shamans or people that is working with the tarot and things like this. So they also are invited to the TV, and this provokes in the population to really be thinking that the shaman is going to tell them when the next earthquake is going to be.
People listening to religious leaders rather than to scientists. That's a phenomenon that's happening in many countries. Let's go to Nigeria, where Adewale, a GYA chemist, lives.
It has always been religious belief. You know, a lot of people believe, they believe in God, and they believe that most of the things you see happening around you are just miracles.
What is it about science and religion? The Wellcome Global Monitor has some interesting results on this topic. Among people with a religious affiliation, 55% would side with their religious teachings in a disagreement between science and their religion. And it's not just Africa where religious beliefs can cause problems for scientists. Among people who say they have a religion, the highest percentages of people who say that science has disagreed with their religious teachings are in the United States and Southern Europe. But there are also many people who think that science and religion are really about different things. So maybe there is no need for disagreement. Aside from that, there are also some problems that all scientists all over the world are facing. At least wherever people own mobile phones with access to social media and the internet.
So sometimes it happens that the information that is loaded by someone else who is not expert in that area could be false. This is because on internet any common person can upload anything and it is circulated within one click of a button. And that is why I feel that the trust in science is increasing.
Shalini, a GYA member from India, works in food engineering. Not long ago, a question trended on Indian social media. Does ordinary wheat flour contain plastic? Videos showing kitchen experiments undertaken by ordinary Indians would have you think so. The scientific explanation was that a high amount of gluten, a naturally occurring protein in wheat, was responsible for the elasticity of wheat flour. But despite this reasonable explanation, people didn't stop worrying about their flour. Flour companies had to implement all kinds of safety protocols and start media campaigns. The topic might be different from country to country, but the effects of false information on the internet are always harmful, one way or another. Fake news on social media, perceived conflicts between religion and science, anti-vaccination movements, and people not knowing what science is about are just a few of the challenges scientists all over the world are facing. There are many more. For example, in some countries, scientists aren't allowed to work freely. In others, women are excluded from most scientific endeavors. And nearly everywhere, young scientists have to work under an extreme amount of pressure. So what can we do about all this? How can we solve all these problems? First of all, there won't be a one-size-fits-all solution, because the problems and circumstances differ from country to country. And second, you are not alone. Connect with your colleagues around the world. Find out what problems they have, and be inspired by how they approach them. In Nigeria, at least Adewale is hopeful that trust in science will increase because more and more people are getting access to a better education.
People get to now know what science is all about as a result of this being taught in school. People know their basic science and they can use this to explain happenings or things happening in their society.
And in many Western countries, science fairs are a great success. They sometimes attract as many visitors as huge concerts by pop stars. And often, the most popular presenters are young scientists, like GYA member Sophie from France.
I like very much to interact with the public, like at science fair where we show small chemistry demonstration, for example, because I can see the passion and the curiosity in the eyes of the public. This is also why I feel that the public has an inherent trust somehow in younger scientists. I have the feeling they don't see us as establishment and that there is like this easy contact that we can make together to discuss around a small experiment, but also to discuss about questions such as climate change.
So, young scientists from all over the world, connect with your society. It's you they're going to trust.